Hello all, welcome to Tutlinks. In this tutorial, we will see how to connect to a Cloud SQL database created on Google Cloud Platform, which is of type PostgreSQL database from a local PC using PgAdmin4. So without further ado, let's get started. So here I am on the browser where I have landed on Google Cloud Platform, cloud.google.com. So when I click on go to console, I'll be landed on the Google Cloud console. So I'll quickly go ahead and create a new project by clicking on this menu and click on the new project. This will be something of the sort Cloud SQL PgSQL project. And what we'll be doing right now is we'll be choosing a billing account, which will be Google Cloud Platform trial billing account. And you can choose your billing account of your choice. I don't have any preference for organization or location. I'll go ahead and create this project. Choose that project. And here we can see the project is selected as Cloud SQL PgSQL. Now what we will do is go ahead and click on this menu icon where we will be seeing the option SQL. Click on this. And what we will do is we'll go ahead and create the instance. So we will choose the database of type PostgreSQL. As we have not enabled this API for the first time, so let's enable the compute engine API. All right, we see that the API has been enabled. So let's land on choose PostgreSQL one more time. So here we will be creating the PostgreSQL instance. So let's start with filling up these details. The instance ID is something that I would like to name as Tutlinks PG instance. And as you can see, it always has to be lowercase, numbers, and hyphens. And it must start with a letter. So a password can be generated, which you can see. Otherwise, you can just have something like a password that you can remember. Once we have the password given, and what we'll do is go ahead and select the version, the database version that is defaultly selected as PostgreSQL 14, but you have a wide range of versions that are available here for you to choose from. The configuration to start with. Here, I'm going ahead with the development configuration, but if you want to have a database that needs to be available for production workloads, you can just choose the production ready button here. You can see here, once I chose the development, you can see the configuration details. You have to choose the region and zonal availability. As you can see, there are various regions that are available to you. The low CO2 regions are the best ones, and at the same time, might be essential for you to deploy your database instance nearer to the location where your customers are being accessing your application from. So I'll go ahead and leave the default option as is, which is US Central 1. And the zonal availability, I can go ahead and choose multiple zones. But for the sake of demonstration, I can go ahead and choose the single zone. The difference between single zone and multi-zone is, if the database instance goes down in your single zone, you will not be able to access your database instance. Whereas with multiple zones, which is highly available configuration, if one of the database servers goes down in one of the zones, the database will look for the instances that were available in a different zone, right? So for the sake of demonstration, I'll go ahead and choose the single zone. If you have any particular preference, you can go ahead and click on primary zones and see within this central one, A, B, C, D are the different zones. So I can go ahead and just choose any and customize your instance. Let's navigate to customize your instance option. I'll go ahead and click on show configuration options. The machine type I'm going to choose as a standard or shared core for the sake of demonstration purposes. You can choose among the wide range of machine types, which are lightweight, standard, and high memory. These are the virtual machines where our PostgreSQL database will be deployed onto. This is the machine type. So I'll go ahead and choose a shared and one vCPU along with 0.1614 GB. of memory. And the storage is something that I can go ahead and choose different types of storage, right? So standard is SSD, which will give you a lower latency in compared to HDD. And you can also go ahead and choose HDD. And the storage capacity is something that is 100 GB, whereas I can go ahead and choose 20 GB or 10 GB. And for the sake of demonstration, I go ahead and choose 10 GB. If you want to have custom size or storage for storage capacity, you can go ahead and do that as well. I'll go ahead and leave this option checked as is in case of my storage reaches out 10 GB, and then I would let this database server instance to automatically increase the storage size. With that in place, let's move on to connections. Connections are something that you will leave the default as is. For the sake of the demonstration, as we are trying to connect to this database instance from the local PC, I will capture my local PC's IP address and add it here in the authorized networks list. If you see this, this is my IP address of my PC, and I'll go ahead and add my PC and the networks. The network text box accepts the standard CDR notation of the IP ranges and IP addresses. After allowing this particular database to be connected from this particular IP, I will be able to establish the connection from my PC, which is having this IP address, to this PostgreSQL instance, which is hosted on Google Cloud Platform. So I'll go ahead and choose done. And data protection, I'll leave all the default options as is. There are automate backups, which you can configure based on the time zone and the times that you are in. You also have the advanced options, such as like choose where to store your backups, where you can have a preference, and the number of backups that you want to have, right? So once you exceed 8, the very old backup will be purged, and you will still have the recent 7 number of backups. I'll leave the enable point in time recovery, which will allow me to recover the data from a specific snapshot that I have had in my list of backups. Let's move ahead for the maintenance. The maintenance is something that typically takes place once every few months and requires your instance to be restarted while the updates are made, right? So you can choose any window unless otherwise you have any options, such as Sunday 12 a.m. to 1 a.m. or something somewhere around like 2 to 3 a.m. I would like to have maintenance. The order of update will be any later or earlier, right? Relative to other instances in this region. So flags, I don't have any flags here. If you want to identify this instance, you can just go ahead and add a flag here, something of that sort. And query insights, I will go ahead and just leave this as the default option, which is not selected. Labels are something that you would like to tag this database server instance. Go ahead with this configuration in place. But remember that as the purpose of the demonstration is not just about creating the Cloud SQL Postgres database. It is also to connect to this database from your local PC. Ensure that your connections section of the database instance has a public IP address checked in, and you are authorizing this database SQL instance such that any requests that are originating from this IP address are authorized to connect to this database, right? So with that in place, let's go ahead and create this instance. Creating a database on Cloud SQL typically takes more than 20 minutes. Let's wait for this database instance to be created. Once it is created, you will be able to see these options highlighted in blue, which you can just act on these buttons, right? So the connection section is something that you can see. If at all you want to connect to this particular instance, right? So you can navigate to the connections section, and in the networking tab, you can find the option authorized network. You can go ahead and add a network, which will be enabled once the database is created. We will come back once this database is created. It's been more than 13 minutes. We see that the database is still being created. So meanwhile, this Cloud SQL database gets spun up in Google Cloud Platform. If at all you want to know how to install PostgreSQL database on your local PC along with PgAdmin,
installing and refer to my video here,
Admin Rights on Windows 11 Operating System. This video tutorial covers the ways to install PostgreSQL on your Windows 11 operating system without you actually needing to have admin rights. So it also covers how to set up your PgAdmin, which is graphical user interface client, which you can use to connect to your either local instance of your database or remote instance of database, such as the one that is hosted on cloud on GCP. All right. So it took almost 25 minutes to create this database instance. As we can see, it is in runnable state. So let's go ahead and click on overview. At any point of time, if you want to access this cloud instance of SQL on cloud platform, click on this menu icon and click on this SQL option, where you will see the instance ID, which is the one that we have just created. Click on this. You can see various options here on the overview screen, such as connect to this instance using this public IP address and the outgoing IP address and the connection name, right? So you can also browse around for various properties and explore. Let's navigate around for connections. Generally, for a few PCs or the PCs in your office might have the dynamic IP instances, which means that every time you reboot or shut down or restart your laptop, you will have a change in your IP address, right? So in such case, go to checkip.amazonaws.com and just enter, and you will see your latest public IP of your operating system. And you can always go ahead and add that or whitelist to that particular laptop or PC, saying like my PC and your network IP address, right? So as I have already added that, I can just go ahead and cancel this. Once you are done adding this IP address as an authorized network, you can go ahead and click on save to reflect those changes. Security is something again that is specific to this particular instance of database. You can go ahead and allow only SSL connections. When it comes to users, there is always a default user which is created as the name Postgres. If at all you forgot your password, you can go ahead and change the password, right? So as I have just edited this instance, it is not allowing me to do so. Okay, so it has done. So you can change the password either by generating a random password, or you can just give the password of your choice, which is 121212 I have chosen for the sake of demonstration. You can go ahead and add another user account also, such as Quicklinks user, and the password will be 12, and click on add. Now we will see two users. One is Postgres and Tutelink user. Currently, we do not have any databases. The Postgres is the database that comes installed by default. Here in the backup section, you will be able to see the list of backups. As we have chosen 7 recent backups will be retained, you will see the 7 backups based on the backup window that the backup will be generated. As we do not have any replicas created, we will not see any replica. If at all you want to have a read replica, you can go ahead and create that. With this setup in this, let's go ahead and launch our PgAdmin, which is installed on my local PC. Right, so here I am on my desktop. I will launch PgAdmin4 and let me enter the password. And this password has nothing to do with the cloud instance. It's set up on my local instance. What we'll do is, I have my local database server of Postgres running, but we have to connect to the cloud instance of database, right? So what I'll do is like register a server here, and the information is something that I can go ahead and give, something like Tutelink's PG instance. It could be any name of your choice, and the host name in the connections tab will be the public IP address of your cloud instance, which you can find here, right? So copy this and provide it here, and the username will be Postgres. The password will be 121212. I'll go ahead and save the password and click on save. If at all you forgot the password, you can always go to the user section and reset the password for that particular user. But ensure that any applications that are relying on this database server also have the latest password reflected. And I see that the database connection has been succeeded, and I'm able to connect to the Tutelink's PG instance. As you can see, I have a default database. Let me go ahead and create a database. The database will be something like GCP Tutelinks DB, and I'll leave the default options as is for all these tabs, and I'll go ahead and click on save. Right, so once I have this saved, I'll just go ahead and see this is created. So I will land back on my Google Cloud console, where I head over to the SQL section. In the databases menu, I should be seeing the latest one. So for that, let me refresh. All right, so here is our latest database that we have just created. All right, so if I just delete it, the service account or the role that I have from this dashboard will not allow me to do that. For example, if you just go ahead and click on delete, you might be provided with an error message saying that invalid request. The user must be the owner of the database. From this connected instance, what you can do is you can go ahead amongst a list of three databases. The one that I have just created, I can go ahead and delete and drop. So this is the advantage that I have when I connect to the Google Cloud instance of database, which is Cloud SQL Database from my local PC using PgAdmin. If I just refresh this page back again, let's see, it might get disappeared. Yeah, it has got disappeared. I hope you enjoyed watching this video.
If you found this video helpful, please give it a like. Please do subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Enjoy your day. Bye.